Praise the living God, Jehovah. I just want to share this. I'm not going to call out no names, though, because I know the individual don't want me to call out their name. But I just want you to know how God is so faithful. He is so good. You know, he tests us, especially when he's giving you a ministry. And the children might do it. It really is not my ministry. It's his. I didn't even come up with the name, the idea. All that came from the Lord Jesus Christ. But you know, in this ministry, I depend on the Lord to supply all our need according to his riches and glory through Christ Jesus. But God will test you. Now, he'll put people in your life and they will bless you spiritually and bless you physically. He'll place people in this ministry who will bless us financially. With a good monthly offering or tithe. And he did it to test me, and to see if I'm going to continue to speak his truth or compromise. Compromise, that means fear if I speak truth, this person may withdraw their financial support. Now, he tested me on that. Did not know that's what he was doing at the time, but now, I see he tests me on that. And dear heart, when the test came, thank you, Jesus, I passed the test. And there have been those who gave to this ministry. They were happy that the Lord had delivered them and saved them. And they blessed us emotionally, physically, financially. Until the Holy Ghost revealed to them their heart. Through the word. Quite naturally, God's servant going to get the blame because they only can see the human being. What they end up doing, they end up falling out with Evangelist King and withdrawing the financial blessing. But do you not know each time that would happen, God would send someone in their place? Well, I don't want God to send anyone in my place. You know, scripture said, don't let the rocks, you know, I praise him before us. Now the rock's going to praise him. But dear heart, when you don't do what God tells you to do, he's not going to force you to do it. He's going to find someone else. There's always someone else in line to take your place. And I have found that whenever that happened, someone, you know, blesses this ministry and end up walking away, God will always send someone in that place. And he sends someone that you wouldn't even think had anything, to be quite honest with you. I was just in shock of this individual who supported the mission and vision of the Children's Might. From a human perspective, you wouldn't have thought such a blessing would come from that person. That's why we don't judge anyone. Don't judge anyone, dear heart, based on how they look. What you think they have or what you think they don't have. You miss your blessing that way. And I just thank God. Because I'm telling you, there have been men. Often the Holy Spirit bring to my mind when Jesus was on earth that he started out actually more than 12 disciples. He had over 500 disciples. But as he continued to speak, what his father would tell him to speak, which is truth, they misunderstood him. And the scripture said they walked away, never to follow him again. So the same Jesus in you and I, some people may start out with you, but if they're not the real deal, the Father did not send them, they'll get offended and walk away, never to join themselves with you again. Because I asked the Lord, I said, Lord, they came back, didn't he? He said, what did my words say? My words say they never walked with him again. I said, what? Never. He said, never. Dear, I just thank God. We got so much to learn here. I see why in the beginning Satan fought me so hard. In the beginning, even before I came to the Lord, the devil fought against me. He was afraid of what I was becoming. He's afraid of what you are becoming. You know, we're not totally in his kingdom, and he knows we are against him. We are becoming like Christ, and he wants to stop it. And a lot of times he's using misunderstandings. Everyone who walked away from this ministry, walked away from Frederick King, Prophet King, they misunderstood what we said and misunderstood what we did. They walked away. Now remember Judas. Judas stayed until the end, but he ended up killing himself. Now, I don't experience that Judas kiss. Every true child of God, every ministry of God is going to experience that Judas kiss. That's a betrayal. And you know the person is against you, but you smile at them as though you don't even know. So again, I just thank God for the blessing that this person have contributed to this ministry financially, that I was able to send fundings to all of the my partners that help out this ministry in their country to help provide food. Not only, you know, for the COVID victim, everybody there in the country is a COVID victim. They may not have COVID, but they are affected by COVID because they can't find work. So I thank God for this individual, because that was on my mind in sending some funding, and it made my heart very happy to be able to do so. So I'm looking forward to the photos and the video clips of that food distribution. And y'all pray for them. Pray for their wisdom in doing these distributions. You know, we're talking about in Namibia, Zimbabwe, Kenya, and Ethiopia. Praise the living God. I tell you, I'm in awe, because I didn't think such blessing would come from a person. God bless you. God gonna continue to add to this person financially, because he already adding spiritually, and that's the most important, adding to this person's life spiritually. So I just want to share that with you, dear heart. And don't let nobody take your place. And Holy Spirit say do, you do. Because if not, he'll find someone to take your place. Praise the living God. Shalom.